Welcome back, class. Let's go ahead and get started with our warm-up. Then we'll do our stretches, and then we're going to play a game called Who Wants to Be a Millionaire? All right, let's get started. Let's start with jogging in place. Let's get pumped like this guy. This guy is ready. He is excited. He's getting his arms moving. His legs are moving. There you go. And jumping jacks. Go ahead and do some jumping jacks. There you go. And back to jogging in place. Now you could jog like this guy, or you could just jog like normal. This guy's a little silly. All right, now let's do some jump rope tricks. So we have our single bounce right here, where you jump every time that the rope spins around. You could do the double bounce, where you bounce in between every jump. You could do the bell, where you are jumping forward and backwards, forward and backwards. Or you can even do the hop, where you are jump roping when you're on one foot. All right. Now back to jogging in place. I like the flash. The flash is super fast. Let's see if you can be just as fast as the flash. Good job. Now let's do some squats. Squat down and up. Squat down and up. Good job. Now back to jogging in place. Want to really get those knees up like you see her doing. Now we're going to do the Heisman exercise where you're going to just hop back and forth from one foot to the other. All right. Kind of look like you're skating on ice. And back to jogging in place. And go ahead and do some jump squats. You're going to squat down and jump up. You're going to squat down and jump up. Very good. You want to like explode upwards. Great job. And back to jogging in place. You can even pretend you're giving a nice little high five to this cat here. I wish my dog would give me a high five like that. And let's finish it off with some butt kicks. You're jogging in place and you're lifting your heels up, so it's like you're kicking your bottom. And relax. All right, let's move on to our stretches. So our first stretch that we're going to do is called walking knee hugs. And what you're going to do is you're going to take a step, then you'll pull your knee up towards your chest, and then release and pull your other knee towards your chest. And this is a really good stretch. It's going to stretch the back of your legs, and it's going to stretch your back and your backside as well. Now this is a dynamic stretch. Dynamic stretching is where we are moving while we are stretching, okay? Usually we go and we do a static stretch where you just hold a certain position for as long as you can. But for this one, we are actually moving and stretching all at the same time. So here's our next one. We're going to do arm circles. Now you can do little arm circles. You can do big arm circles. You can do arm circles while moving forward. You can do arm circles backwards. You could alternate your arms for arm circles. There's so many ways you can do this. and windmill toe touches. Now what you're going to do is spread your arms and your feet apart, and you're going to reach your arm across to the opposite foot, and then stand up tall, and then do the same on the other side. Your other hand is going to touch your opposite foot. Very good. Keep going back and forth, back and forth. Now we're going to transition to the floor. Let's go ahead and do our favorite, which is the butterfly stretch. If you want, you can even flap those wings. That can make it a dynamic stretch as opposed to a static stretch. So good job. And when you're ready, we're going to now do a quad stretch while we are lying down. So you're going to lay down on your side, and then you're going to pull your foot towards your bottom while keeping your body nice and straight. And now relax. You're going to switch, and we're going to do the same on the other side. So go ahead and switch on to your other side. Pull your foot towards your bottom, and you'll feel that stretch while keeping your body nice and straight. Now we're going to do our seated hip flexion. For this one, you're going to bend both of your knees and have your hands behind you. And then what you're going to do is you're going to cross one of your ankles over across the other knee, okay? And you're going to feel that stretch in your hip, okay? All right, when you're ready, go ahead and switch, and we're going to do the same on the other side. You're going to have your knees bent, your hands behind you, and then you're going to cross your ankle over across your knee. And once again, you'll feel that stretch in your hip. All right, now we're going to switch, and we're going to do our seated back twist. When we do this one, you're going to just have your legs straight out in front of you, and then you're going to bend one knee. And what you can do is you can cross your foot over so that it's on the other side of your straight leg, and you can twist towards that bent knee, as you can see she is doing here in the picture. Now switch, you're going to do the same on the other side. So you're going to straighten your leg that was bent. Now your other leg is going to bend, and you're going to place that foot on the other side of the straight leg and twist towards your bent knee. Right, now we're going to do our lower back stretch. For our lower back stretch, you are going to lay flat on your back. You're going to bend one knee, and you're going to just rotate it across your body. And then when you're ready, go ahead and switch and do the same on the other side. And go ahead and relax. All right, class. Now we are going to play our game of Who Wants to Be a Millionaire? All right. So this is a game show that is played on TV. And what it is there's going to be somebody who's going to try and answer these questions. And if they answer correctly, they win that money and move up to the next level. and the next and the next until they go to the final round where hopefully all together they can win $1 million. Now, I wish I had $1 million to give you, but I don't. So instead, maybe you can make a deal with your family or whoever you're playing with that if you end up winning Who Wants to Be a Millionaire, then maybe next time you play Monopoly, you get to start with $1 million or whatever deal you want to make with your family members. But this is just a nice fun game that you can play. So what's going to happen is we're going to answer these questions, and then in between every question, we're going to do an exercise, because not only are we going to exercise our brain, we're also going to exercise our bodies. So win-win. All right, let's get started. I'm going to click here to begin. First question, which activity will make your heart beat the fastest? A, reading. B, reaching for toes. C, sleeping. Or D, running. I will start the timer. Time is up, and our correct answer for $100 is D, running. All right, so great job on that one. So for our exercise, let's go ahead and stand up and jog in place. We're going to go running for 15 seconds. Want to get those arms moving, those legs moving. Want to get some exercise in. All right, on to our next question. Which exercise is a flexibility exercise? A, planks. B, jumping jacks. C, butterfly stretch. Or D, squats. Start the timer and good luck. All right, time is up, and looks like for $200, the correct answer is butterfly stretch C. All right, so yes, butterfly stretch is a flexibility exercise. So let's go ahead and do the butterfly stretch. All right, go ahead and do that butterfly stretch while I get started on reading the next question for you. Which exercise is a cardiovascular endurance exercise? A, downward dog pose. B, burpees. C, walking. Or D, playing video games. All right, time is up, and for $300, our correct answer is B, burpees. All right, burpees are definitely a great cardiovascular endurance exercise. So let's go ahead and do some burpees. Remember, you're going to go down to the ground, do a push-up, you're going to get back up and jump straight up. You're going to go down, do a push-up, get up and jump straight up. All right, do one more. You're going to go down to the ground, do a push-up, get up, and jump straight up. Great job. All right, next question. What is a healthy snack? A, apple, B, Takis, C, French fries, or D, Coke? Starting the timer. All right, looks like our correct answer for $400 is A for apple. Yes, apples are a fantastic healthy snack and they give you quick energy, and those are fantastic. So let's look at our exercise. We're going to do some lunges. So you're going to take a large step forward, lower your knee towards the ground, and then step back. And then you're going to step with your other foot, take a large step forward, lower your knee towards the ground, and then step back. You want to make sure that you are keeping your legs at a 90-degree angle, all right? A 90-degree angle, in other words, like the corner of a box, the corner of a square, all right? As you see, her other leg in the back is looking like that, and her front leg as well. So good job. Let's go on to our next question. Which of the following is an exercise? A, jumping rope, B, eating vegetables, C, eating fruit, or D, watching TV? All right, looks like the correct answer for our $500 question is A, jumping rope. Yes, jumping rope, that is an exercise. Eating vegetables and eating fruit, those are fantastic ways to stay healthy. Those are just not exercises. And then watching TV, not so much. That's not an exercise. All right, let's go ahead and do some jumping. Excuse me. All right, so you're going to have your feet together, swing your arms back and then forward. And I want you to try to jump as far as you can. All right. So what you're going to do is you're going to swing your arms back. And whenever you swing your arms forward and you're going to explode on up and forward and try to land as far away as you can from your starting point. All right. And next question. Which of the following is a sport? A, basketball, B, football, C, soccer, or D, all of the above? All right. For $1,000, the correct answer is D, all of the above. Yes, all three of those are sports that you could possibly play. All right, let's go ahead and let's practice our best basketball shot. All right, and we're going to practice some basketball shooting. So you want to go in and you want to pretend that you're holding this imaginary ball in your hand, your dominant hand, the other hand right here on the side to protect it. And you're going to extend your arm and follow through. The follow through is a flick of the wrist. So you're going to extend and follow through, extend and follow through. There you go. And if you're ready, you can add a little bit of a jump in like Kobe Bryant is doing right here. He added quite a big jump in there, but He definitely was one of the greatest of all times, that's for sure. All right, next question. When you exercise, you will breathe A, softer, B, faster, C, slower, or D, you won't breathe at all. All right, the correct answer for $2,000 is B, faster. When you exercise, your heart will definitely, or your lungs will definitely breathe faster. So let's go on and make our lungs work hard by doing some mountain climbers. That you're in the push-up position, and then you're just powering those knees forward and then powering them and powering them as if you are climbing up a mountain. All right. So good job. And next question. Having good sportsmanship means A, saying ha ha when someone messes up, B, kicking dirt on someone, C, saying good job after a game, or D, hitting another kid. All right, having good sportsmanship. What would that mean? All right, our correct answer for $4,000 is C, saying good job after a game. Yes, that is what having good sportsmanship looks like. All right, those other three options, those are bad sportsmanship. You do not want that. Let's go ahead and do five sit-ups. Make sure when you do these sit-ups that you are sitting all the way up and then all the way back down. Now, if you're having a hard time sitting all the way up without your feet coming off the floor, then you could have somebody hold your feet down to help you out. That is perfectly fine. Next question, which of these is a healthy breakfast? A, pancakes with a lot of syrup. B, eggs with a banana and orange juice. C, waffles with lots of butter. Or D, sugar cereal. All right, our correct answer for the $8,000 is B, eggs with a banana and orange juice. Now, pancakes, those aren't like a terrible breakfast. They can be very yummy and it can also be very healthy depending on how you make it and what you add to it. The thing is, if you have a lot of syrup and a lot of sugar on top, like the syrup has lots of sugar or whipped cream, stuff like that, then it makes it where it's not so healthy. But if you had some pancakes where you had slices of bananas and strawberries on top, maybe some almonds, it would be very yummy and had some healthy components. All right. And same with the waffles and then cereal. It's best to have some cereal that's not sugar-based. So, word of advice. But for our exercise, let's hold the plank for 10 seconds. Remember, you're going to hold that push-up position. You could either have your hands on the ground or your forearms on the ground, but try to hold it for the full 10 seconds. All right, next question. What happens to your heart rate when you exercise? A, it speeds up. B, nothing. C, it stops. Or D, it slows down. All right, the correct answer for $16,000 is A, it speeds up. Yes, whenever you are exercising, your heart rate is going to speed up. All right, that is a good thing for whenever you are exercising. So let's go ahead and make our heart rate speed up by doing some bicycle kicks. All right, remember you're going to lay flat on your back with your legs pedaling like you're riding a bike. And if you want, you can twist your upper body so that it can be nice and challenging. But if you don't want to twist your upper body, you don't have to. You can just pedal your legs like you're riding a bike. Good job. And next question. What else happens to your body when exercising? A, you feel cold. B, your eyes start running. C, you get out of breath and feel cold. Or D, you get out of breath and feel warm. All right. All right, the correct answer for $32,000 is D, get out of breath and feel warm. Yes, whenever you are exercising, your body is definitely going to get out of breath and it's going to get warmer. So that's a good thing. Like if you start to sweat when you're exercising, that means you are working really hard. So good job. Let's go ahead and work up a sweat and do some squats. So you're going to squat down and back up. Squat down and back up. Squat down and back up. All right, next question. What type of footwear is best for PE? A, sandals. B, running shoes. C, flip-flops. Or D, slippers. All right, the correct answer for $64,000 is B, running shoes. Yes, that is definitely the correct type of footwear that you should wear for PE. Okay, that'll keep your feet safe and it will also help support you. So let's do some jump squats in those running shoes. Squat down and you explode up. You squat down and you explode up. Good job. Next question. Josh likes donuts. But what will happen if Josh only eats donuts, like every day, all day, and that's the only thing Josh eats? A, he will be very happy. B, he will turn into a donut. C, he will dream about donuts. Or D, he will become ill. Another word for ill is sick. Thank you. All right, the correct answer for $125,000 is D. He will become ill. And that is absolutely correct. If all you eat is donuts every day, all day, and that's the only thing you eat, that's not good. All right. Donuts, they aren't even very nutritious for you. Those are more like a treat you should have every once in a while. What you do need to have is you need to have a balanced diet, your balanced meals throughout the day. So you need to get some veggies in during the day, some fruit, you need some dairy, like milks and cheese and stuff like that. And then you need to get some protein in, so like some different meats or beans, and you need some carbs. So whether that's going to be with pasta, potatoes, or rice, but there's so many different options. But yes, you want to have a nice, well-balanced diet and meals throughout the day. Okay. So our exercise, we're going to do some flutter kicks. So you're going to lay flat on your back, elevate your legs and keep them straight, and just flutter them back and forth like you are swimming in the ocean. All right, next question. Which of these is the healthiest option? A, cake and cookies. B, fruits and vegetables. C, potato chips and donuts. Or D, ice cream and candies. All right. Our correct answer for $250,000 is B, fruits and vegetables. Those are most definitely the healthiest option there. Let's go ahead and do the airplane pose. So you're going to balance on one leg while extending your other leg straight behind you, and you're going to lean forward, and you can put your arms out like they're the wings of a plane. That can help you balance. Very nice. Now go ahead and switch. You're going to do the same on your other leg, and you're going to balance on that leg. And anything we do on one side, we always want to do to the other to keep our body nice and balanced. All right, on to our second to last question. We need a variety of foods to grow and stay healthy. What else do we need to stay healthy? A, ice cream. B, chocolate. C, water. Or D, chips. All right, our $500,000 question. That's $500,000. Let's see. C, water is the correct answer. And yes, that is absolutely correct. We do need a variety of foods to grow and stay healthy, but you also need water. Water is extremely important. So make sure you're always drinking enough water. All right, we are on to our last exercise, which is jumping jacks. Let's do 15 jumping jacks. All right, our final question. It is our $1 million question. Let's see. What does PE stand for? A, pro energy. B, program elite. C, physical education, or D, popular education? All right. So the answer to our $1 million question, do you think you got it right? Let's see. It is C, physical education. All right. So congratulations. You won a total of $1 million. Now, whether that means Monopoly money or bragging rights, it's completely up to you all. But thank you so much for playing and exercising today. And I hope you all have a wonderful day. And I will see you again next week. Bye.